All right, so exceptions enable processes. So a process is a running program. So if you have one program stored on disk, you can potentially have many copies of that program running at any given point. And so you can potentially have many processes associated with the same program. This is an abstraction, like we said, provided by the operating system kernel, which is another one-to-many relationship because there is one kernel that's ever running with many user processes that it's supporting. This is a sort of a shared portion of the virtual address space that we haven't really talked about before. So this is kernel memory, which is located sort of at the top of the address space, even above the stack. And this region typically is not visible to user programs, which is why we have not really been talking about it before. So the exceptions that we've talked about earlier are used to control processes by the operating system. And so it's kind of this cooperation between the operating system, which is mediating between the hardware and the software, and the user processes, which are communicating with the operating system. So the primary mechanism for controlling processes is through interrupts. So the operating system can start a process running, and then it can interrupt it using an interrupt, and then cycle through those processes using this technique called round-robin scheduling, where you suspend one process that's running and you begin the next process. There are traps as well. Traps allow for communication between processes and kernels by allowing the user processes to make a function call into the kernel, so we call these system calls. Faults enable the recovery or aborting due to some sort of software error as the program is running, and then an abort allows the operating system to stop a process without necessarily taking down the machine if the abort is contained just to that one program. So processes are implemented by the operating system kernel. So the kernel maintains a data structure that has all of the process information for each process, including an ID for each process, which is referred to as the process ID or the PID. And multitasking, again, is implemented via exceptional control flow. So this is sort of one of the key concepts here, which is that the operating system can allow multiple processes to appear as though they're running simultaneously on a CPU by periodically interrupting the running program, pausing it, saving its state, and then switching to a new process. And this is, if you give each of the processes a turn, this is referred to as round-robin switching. And so the process of switching between processes is referred to as a context switch, and it involves three steps. So you have to save the context of the old process, including any registers or any other information that's needed in order to resume the program, including the program counter, right, where it is currently executing. It needs to restore the context of the new process, so any registers in the saved program counter from that process the last time it was suspended. And then you, of course, have to pass control to the restored process and let the CPU begin executing it again. So the way that exceptions are implemented under the hood is that there is an exception table stored by the kernel where every exception is assigned a unique ID. And when an exception occurs, the exception ID is used as a lookup into that table, which is essentially a pointer to the code that needs to be run in kernel memory in order to handle the exception. So, as we said, a process is an instance of an executing program, and so this is an independent single logical flow and private virtual address space. So a logical flow is a sequence of executed instructions, just one instruction executing after another. And so now we can see that we can have what's called concurrency, which is overlapping logical flows. So we can have two different processes that are running, and they're running concurrently. And they may not be running simultaneously, but they may be sort of running in the same space of time. And multitasking is when you have concurrent processes that are taking turns on a single CPU. So one logical flow, one process is running its logical flow, and then the CPU, the operating system interrupts it, switches to another, and that one gets a slice of the time, and then we switch back to the first one. So this is multitasking. And then, of course, if we have multiple CPUs or multiple cores, we can have concurrent flows that are actually running at the same time. And this is what's called parallelism.